What's up, millionaires? It's your boy Millionaire E coming at you with a movie review. And the movie we're going to be talking about is Who Framed Roger Rabbit. Now, before we get started, spoiler alert for anyone who's not seen the movie. I don't want to spoil it for you. And also, for my directors in the future, or my directors in the making, or directors just in general, please do not remake this movie. And the only reason why I say that is because it's a really, really good movie. And it's a lightning strikes once kind of situation. And also, I was kind of feeling a little bit kind of about the, you know, Lola Bunny situation where they were like, she was way too sexualized in the first movie, and now they kind of made her a little bit, which, when I was watching it, I was like, you know what, I'm okay with it. I'm just like, in this movie, I don't know about this. Like, wait till you see Jessica Rabbit. Like, you see her in this picture right here? It gets worse in the movie. Like, Jessica Rabbit is just way overly portionated. Like, to a T. And I'm like, I don't know. Y'all don't do that. That's just all I'm saying. Because like I said, you think Lola Bunny is bad? Wait, you get Jessica Rabbit. But, you know what I'm going to do? I'm going to talk about the good stuff and the bad stuff. Now, I love crossovers. I love it when one character from a whole different universe meets another character from a whole different universe. Like, examples, Sonic and Mega Man. You know, Space Jam New Legacy, or even Space Jam itself, or, you know, Looney Tunes Back in Action. Like, that's where we kind of, it was different types of crossover. And I love that. And I feel like with this movie, it had a lot of crossovers in it. And, you know, the theme of the movie first is kind of like a murder mystery. Eddie Valiant, who is a tune hater, or he disdains tunes. And the reason why he disdains tunes is because a tune killed his brother. And the only thing that he knows about this tune and the characteristics are his bloodshot eyes, piercing bloodshot eyes, and a high-pitched voice. And remember, but, like I said, with all the characters, they have all these different characters in the movie. Like, you have Betty Boo, then there's even two scenes where you have literally Bugs Bunny and Mickey Mouse in the same room. And I'm like, you wouldn't see that, because it's like, you got Disney, Warner Brothers. They wouldn't do that. And I'm like, there's even another scene where it's got, you got Donald Duck and Daffy Duck. And you know, Donald has a speech impediment, and Daffy's like, what the heck? This dude, I don't understand what this dude's talking about. And it's just so cool to see that. And I'm like, that's what I love about the movie, is it's the crossover aspect. And then there's other aspects of it. I love the literal Toontown. And this world is set around Toontown. You know, Space Jam New Legacy was set around, you know, a serververse, which was kind of like the multiverse. Toontown is where all the toons live. So, you know, Bugs Bunny, you even saw Yosemite Sam, all those characters live in it. And in Toontown, anything could happen. You got, like, houses made out of toons, toon lamps, toon cars. For example, you know, Benny, the toon cab. It's like all different types of toon stuff is in Toontown. I'm like, that's so cool. I would love if that was in real life. Now, I know that in Disney, they had kind of like, you know, a Toontown. Now, I don't know if it's destroyed or not. There was a ride with Roger Rabbit. You rode in a Benny ride. I've never rode in it. I wish I want to ride in it. But it was so cool. And then another thing was, there was also at the end of the movie, you saw, you know, a lot more characters that was in the crossover. Like, you know, Goofy. And then you saw the Three Caballeros. And the Three Caballeros were characters that, they were like a singing group. A Disney singing group. And you've got Donald Duck in it, and then you have some other characters, I don't remember their names. And I think, if I'm not mistaken, they have a ride in Epcot, which is a cool ride. I've rode it, it's a really, really cool ride. I love dark rides, where all you get the animatronics moving, but that's on point. So, you know, the movie, as I said, is set around the murder mystery. And the only bad thing about the movie, and it's not really a bad thing, is we have Judge Doom. Not Dr. Doom, Judge Doom, played by Christopher Lloyd. And if you don't know who Christopher Lloyd is Rich Skoltz, my best Back to the Future impression. One of the movies that I do love as well, because I love the concept of time travel. But Judge Doom, this man was terrifying, because he was just straight evil. And then also, this was like, they were like, this is the man who created his first toon killer, or toon killing serum. And what this stuff does, it literally melts a toon. And I was like, whoa, that is just creepy. Because it was like, toons can't, if you don't know, toons can't be killed. You can hit a toon in the head, drop an anvil on his head, a toon will not die. But this guy actually created something that will melt toons. And it was so, like, I was sitting there like, oh my gosh, that is dark. But that's not the thing that I don't like about the movie. The only thing that I don't like about the movie is at the end of the movie, we finally find out that this Judge Doom is the toon that killed Eddie's brother. Because we saw his sharpened, piercing eyes, and then, you know, his high-pitched voice, which is very, very hilarious. And then, you know, he could create buzz saws out of his hands and stuff. And I was like, it was so cool. But the thing is, he died by the toon serum, the toon killing serum. And all we saw was a mask. And it was like, we never got to see his real face. And I was like, man, I wish we could have saw his real face. And even at the end of the movie, they were like, you know, I wonder what he was. I wonder if he was a pig, or, you know, a mouse, or maybe a dog. And I was like, it was so cool. And I was like, it's more of kind of a lesser thing that I wish I could have saw his face. But I'm like, I'm glad it's going to stay a mystery. Now, overall, I would say I give the movie about a 90. And only reason why a 90, I was like, it was just that minor detail that I wish I could have saw Judge Doom's face. And, you know, also that's the cool thing I forgot to tell you was they had Porky Pig in there. He's like, everybody, move out. That's all, folks. And then he's like, oh, wow, that sounds funny. So he turns around. He goes, that's all, folks. And I'm like, that's really cool. But if you've seen the movie, kind of tell me what you think about it. And like the video, y'all. Share it with your fam. And if you're subscribed, click that bell icon to be notified for more videos. And I'll see y'all later, millionaires. And have a blessed day. Bye, y'all.